Hey everyone, Marco Spatafora here from Whole Lotta Drumming. Today we're going to do something a little different. We are going to use the practice pad and going to show you some neat exercises that you can do when all you have is your practice pad to work with. Stay tuned. Okay, so here's the scenario. I'm actually in a hotel room in Frankenmuth, Michigan, doing the show here for the next couple of days. So all I have is this practice pad to work with. Now, here's the thing. How often do you practice with the practice pad? I mean, I can speak on behalf of myself. I hardly ever practice on a practice pad. You know why? Because I have my drum kit. And it's a distraction, right? You go on your drum kit, the last thing you want to do is practice on a practice pad. So it's challenging for me. So when I get a situation like this where I have no choice, I'm in a hotel room, I'm stuck, and all I have is this, now I have an amazing opportunity to work on my hands, okay? And this practice pad is an amazing tool. It really, really, really forces you to work on your hands where you can get control. The exercises you do on a practice pad is like the push-ups and sit-ups of drumming, so to speak. So let's quickly dive into this. What are we gonna do today? Well, I thought today I would focus on the fingers. I'm gonna show you a neat exercise that will develop your fingers. Now, for those of you who already have their fingers developed, this exercise will be a great maintenance exercise. And for those of you who have just started working with the fingers, this exercise will take it to the next level. And for those of you who haven't started yet with their fingers, you know, mainly playing with the wrists, this is a great start. Let's start with the right hand. Now, I am a conventional grip player, so I'm going to start with the right hand. So for those of you who play match grip, you just do what the right hand does with your left hand. And for those of you who are conventional players like myself, I'm going to show you what to do with the right hand and how to also achieve the same effect with your conventional grip. The idea here is we want to develop each finger separately, so that when you apply all fingers, it's just going to give you that much more control and strength. So we start off with the fulcrum, and all you want to do is isolate the fulcrum and just play it over and over and over until you have the control. So you want to really establish even heights like this. All right, so do that for a while until you are able to get the control. If it's all over the place like this and it starts to slide, well, that's a sign that you need to continue being there until you can do this. Once you have that, let's focus now on this finger, the third finger and the fulcrum only. Once you have control, let's do the fulcrum and the fourth finger. Now, it's not going to look pretty, your hand that is, but as long as you are using that fourth finger in the fulcrum, that's all we want to achieve here. If you notice, I have even heights all the way through. Okay, do that for a while until you have the control. And then finally the fulcrum and the fifth finger, your pinky, okay? Now it's gonna look from that angle, it's gonna look like my fourth finger is involved, but it actually isn't. From the other camera angle, you can clearly see that it's my pinky here and the fulcrum. Okay, so do that until you have control. Now, for the left hand, for the conventional grip players, we want to do the same thing. What's the fulcrum in this grip? It's this. This is the fulcrum. Now it might slide and slip and move all the way around, so you have to control that, okay? So that's the idea, is to isolate that, play it over and over until you finally have control. Okay, then you do the fulcrum and the second finger. Try to get rid of these three fingers, or just get them out of the way. Okay, and then fulcrum and third finger. That one there is a little tricky. As you saw, I kind of went crazy there for a second. But that is the idea, is to isolate the fulcrum with each individual finger until you have control. Why? Because once you can do that, then it's easy to incorporate all the fingers. Here's what I suggest. Once you can do that individually, let's apply the metronome. You can do any exercise you want, but I'm just going to show you what I like to do. So I'd like to put it on 80 beats per minute. I'm going to do 4 bars of 16th notes for each finger. Check it out. Okay, so that's one exercise, and here's another exercise you can do after you've done that, is you're going to repeat over and over. You're going to do 1 bar of 16th notes per finger, and you're just going to keep rotating that for as long as you like. So here's an example. Now, you can take this to another level, pick up the speed, maybe bring it up to 90 beats per minute, and maybe you can do like a, you know, half a bar of each finger. Let's try that and see what happens. Well, there you have it. A great, great way to develop your fingers with this isolation type exercise. Once again, the idea is once each finger has achieved the level of control that's desired, when it comes time to actually use all the fingers, it'll be a lot easier. Let me give you a little example. I'm just going to put this at 126. And I'm just going to fool around a little bit using, you know, all the fingers, and to demonstrate how much easier it is to pull off this kind of stuff when you do these isolated finger exercises. Well, that's all the time we have for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have, thumbs up, that would be amazing. What are some of the practice pad exercises that you like to do? Drop a comment below, let me know, I'd love to hear from you. For those of you who haven't subscribed yet, subscribe and you'll always be up to speed with my latest videos. Well, folks, thank you for joining me here. Stay safe, stay well. And we'll see you on the next episode of Whole Lotta Drumming. Take care. Bye-bye.